seat, it's bad. And we haven't built our economy, we haven't built certainly the ag economy on that process. Hybrids and the great quadrupling of productivity we had over the last 9 years in the United States, it continues to make us food independent. So I know American farmers and ranchers are up to the challenge of using these new tools, but there is that narrative out there that's anti-science, anti-innovation. And we saw that, Tom, in this non-GMO movement that has been so out there. So I guess I like to call that the fear of your food movement. So what's your answer?
Well, it's interesting because there's the science answer and then there's the public perception answer. A few years ago, the American Association for the Advancement of Science, the largest independent science organization in the world, here in Washington, surveyed their members about the safety of GMOs, genetically modified organisms, which is actually an awful word to use, but it implies that food is an organism, and it's not. It's really seeds we're talking about. And climate change issues, and found out that a higher percentage of scientists embrace the safety of GMO foods and believe that the climate change is real and caused by human intervention. Yet, when you look at what the public believes, it's one quarter of what the science community believes. So there's a disconnect here. And I think it's really important that we underscore that the genetics is really what agriculture has always been about, as you mentioned. Hybrids are accepted all over the place. And it's incorporated in